Hey, it's Fran, again. And I'm back in Washington, D.C., the most hated city in America. But it is home to the Smithsonian and the National Air and Space Museum, where I am going to be joining Adam Savage and his crew for the monumental building of the Apollo 11 Project Egress hatch.
Because on Venus, it's 900 degrees.
This is a veritable space fair, is what this is. We got live music on the stage.
They got atmospheres, their gravity is alike, and they're both pretty close to the sun.
50 million. This is an actual moon rock.
An actual sample from the moon. It was brought back from Apollo 17. So 1972. This is the larger sample. It was Harrison Schmidt who actually collected this sample. So this is the actual little piece that's right there.
And we were
yes, touch, please touch.
Okay, this is an apology.
Did you get chills?
I got chills.
Oh,
I know.
Thank you for
no problem.
The thrill.
Have a great day.
All right.
Yeah, sure. Yeah. Like it.
Thank you.
Like it.
I just touched a moon rock. I just touched a moon rock. For real. Wow. Harrison Schmidt, the geologist astronaut, brought that rock from the moon, Apollo 17, and I just touched it with my bare finger. Ah, gotta love Apollo 50. Not even at the Smithsonian yet, and already touched a moon rock. I've got moon rock on my fingers. Real moon rock atoms on my fingers. I've touched the moon, for real. And my latch is in there. It's over there, right there in that building. Let's go inside. Things have really changed here since the last time I was here. I got the Mercury capsule behind glass, Freedom 7, and they brought the LEM out here, LEM 2, out in the front lobby. Interesting thing about LEM 2 is that I had learned from the curators that the upper brass was not very happy with the fact that I took apart a disky back in 2014, but they told me, the curators told me, that it was because of that teardown that we did of that real disky that they were able to get all the information and skills that they needed to install a disky in this very LEM when they restored it a couple years ago. So it was a win-win. I was really glad to get a nod that my little project actually helped restore this LEM. Pretty cool. Glamorous Glennis. Spaceship One. Spirit of St. Louis. And LEM 2.
Hi, my husband's a fan. We were watching your YouTube video interview today. The walnut.
Yeah, all right, yeah. Thanks. Enjoy. I'm waiting to see it. I haven't even been over there yet. So. It's in a corner. I'm still looking for it. So
I saw your part. Nice.
Thank you.
They asked you to make it an open.
No, I chose.
So it's supposed to be different mediums.
It was our choice. You know, whatever you wanted to do. Thank you. All right. Fans are ready. So yeah. I haven't even got out of the lobby and already. Already, the reality Fran lab is in. Yeah. This is the real deal. This is the real model that they restored. One that was made for the original TV show. And the only thing about the documentary that really upset me was that they replaced all of the incandescent bulbs with LEDs. So. Yeah, they improved it, in air quotes, but I think that that's sort of a cop-out. I think the original look with the original incandescents would have been super awesome. So, but yeah, they repainted it and everything. But yeah, that's the original model. I mean, they've really changed things around since the last time I was here. They got the mock-up of Skylab. And the last remaining A4 V2 von Braun rocket. Very last. Soyuz over there in the distance. And we're headed to the special area, the secret area. Here is the Beyond Earth Gallery.
Okay. Thank you.
Like work is in progress. Already got it on the Jumbotron.
I think we're fine right now.
The shuttle engines right there.
When this starts to shoot
off. Oh, here he is. Skittle emergency. That's my box right there. Not yet opened. I said they'd be bringing tools for every possible contingency, and it looks like that's very true.
So from now on, like, it can link up and it'll tell her where to look. This crate is one thing.
Oh, no way. They included all the stickers. Oh, that's beautiful. Did you see this?
Oh, my gosh.
They included all the stickers and the labeling and everything. Incredible. Those madmen. Madmen and women.
Until we put it onto the stand.
Okay.
So we'll assemble the stand and put the hatch.
Sure. You want to get John's muscle in?
Guess I was
in the shop.
Come on over. I would love that. Yeah, come on over. the labels.
You love that? It's
love
Thomas.
It.
Yeah,
love
it's Thomas McCrazy.
What's that? Yeah. Very good. How are you?
Metal, the base is low, yeah. There's a bunch of it.
It's funny. Make sure it's going under the room like that.
Yeah.
And that kind
of. Yeah, it's very cool.
Yeah, you squish it and just put it on the
yep, how about that one? It's off the hardware. Yeah. Okay. There's two plates there. That one's on top.
Good.
Oh no, the wooden nails are all.
Got it?
That is a big crate. I forgot about that. Some fitting problems. Can't get the shot.
Build all the time. That was fun.
Every now and then it sinks in the absurdity. No, it's not coming out.
Adam, what made you pick the
command
module
out? It seemed easy.
Hey, Adam, you're cracking in the side.
It's cracking in the side.
Here, I'm going to fix that right now.
We're trying not to. Okay, that's
fine. Crack. Just came by and gave me this, this bag, and contains a book, Where No Man Has Gone Before, History of Apollo Lunar Exploration Missions, official NASA publication, and also Project Apollo, The Tough Decisions, another official NASA book. And real Apollo stickers. Apollo 50. Cool. All right. Thanks, Carl.
Also, low pilot.
All right. Wow. That's the camera that they replaced on Hubble, the original camera. That was flown. And there's the Hubble right there. The model of it, anyway. Not the actual one. It's big. It's standing next to it, it is absolutely humongous. It's like the size of a building. Incredible.
still got microscopic moon rock on my finger. This is one of the suits that I wore on 15. Scott's suit.
Problems with the tolerances, and so they've had to drill out all these holes for the window, and I guess because the holes don't really line up, they've drilled them out and they're gluing the screws in place, so it's purely cosmetic. So yeah, there's looks like they're having a lot more fit issues than they anticipated, because we're well an hour two. Hour and a half in. So, the gearbox assembly is all laid out on the table. That's it, it's going full speed right now, but they're definitely hitting problems. One of the hinges got broken in shipping, and they're re-gluing it, but I do wonder if that's going to hold. It's got to hold the weight of the whole hinge, so
not a bad deal, huh?
It looks like I wasn't the only one who used wood. Looks like that's been out of wood. Or is it cardboard? Or MDF? That looks like MDF. That's interesting. That one looks like something from Tron. Those look pretty cool. People have definitely done different themes for the latches. Slowly unpacking all the parts and laying them out on the sheets that we got. It's a bunch of latches.
Fran wants to know if you're actually out of the cabin.
Just shown my latch. Just one latch. Matches have started.
Focus. Let's see. There we go. Let's see how she's holding the plans.
Looks like I'm gonna go counterclockwise. Latch installations. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Thank you.
Armstrong took to the surface of the moon, some food that they had, and flashlights they took, and one of the cameras that they brought back, one of the scopes from the Starfinder, and that was just amazing. Really crazy. Quite a number of fans come up and stop me, so. It's been a very long day, and I'm very appreciative, always.
Yeah,
sure. I'm gonna go upstairs and take a look at Neil Armstrong's restored spacesuit. All right, we're going in to see Neil Armstrong's suit with the thermal hood. There it is. Still going on. It's well past 3 o'clock, and there's just so much going on in here. I'm struggling to keep track of everything that's going on stage, completely ignoring all the artifacts like this space shuttle engine and this model, which was Von Braun's space station model, which they had in a Disney film, which I've seen several times this week. It's one of Von Braun's ideas for having an orbiting space station. This is the model they built that he appeared with in that film. Look at that motor. Yeah, it's after 3 o'clock. Got less than an hour to finish this up. Basically come down to just doing the gluing and epoxying things in place that were either broken or loose. It's really coming down to the wire. We just got a few more minutes to go till we're out of time. Epoxy and tape for that broken hinge. Looks like, yeah, more tape. Yeah. Getting down to the last few minutes. Yep, 4 4:02, so we're actually over time. I hate the smell of epoxy, I really do. It smells like burning hair and pus.
Yes, actually.
Well, my part didn't have to be taped and epoxied. Sitting right there. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
plastic off of this one?
Oh, yeah, I do.
I was going to ask you to put that in, but right there.
To Jen Schachter, who shepherded. A hand for all the makers present who contributed to this beautiful object. A hand for the Smithsonian for allowing a bunch of makers to come in and mess up the joint. And Andrew Barth took a scan from the Smithsonian of this hatch that was basically like a surface scan, and somehow in his brain figured out how all these linkages worked and drew them all in like, I don't know,
2 months.
A hand for Andrew. Testing family came to this, so please give a hand to them for helping. Now that all the makers who contributed to come up on stage and sign their work, please, if you would.
Mission accomplished. It's done. So that's it for me. I'll see you back in the lab after I've come back down to Earth. I'm still orbiting the moon right now. And thanks everyone for making this possible. All those great patrons and all the fans and the ones I met today, thank you. I'm Fran. I gotta go back to Earth now. It's been quite a ride.